Our next topic is gene therapy. So gene therapy basically works by fixing defective genes. First, you have to identify a disease-causing allele. Remember, an allele is a specific version of a gene. And then you have to replace or supplement the disease-causing allele with a healthy version. And then ideally, the disease is completely cured. There's two methods that this is done. There's ex vivo. This is when you remove the cells from the body, add the healthy allele, and then return the cells to the body. The other option is in vivo, and this uses viruses to deliver genes to specific cells in the body. And it turns out, if you think about it, viruses are perfect for this because they tend to specialize on certain cell types, and they inject their own DNA inside our cells. So you can engineer the viruses with the gene you particularly want and have it deliver for you. So there's some issues that have come up with gene therapy. This was a big promise about 20, 30 years ago. And then a couple people actually died during gene therapy trials. And so it was stopped. Now we're back and sort of tentatively trying some additional ways. One of the issues is, how do we make sure that a virus only reaches the target cells? What if it infects cells that we don't want to be changed? How do you control that virus? What if the virus mutates into something else and actually causes more problems? Another issue is the potential side effects of suppressing immune response. When you inject a virus into someone, your immune system is going to kick in and try and get rid of that virus. So if you're treating someone with gene therapy, you actually have to purposely reduce their immune response. And there could be other side effects to that. While the virus you want is going to specific places, you aren't fighting other viruses. One of the concerns is that cancer could be a possible side effect. As cells are infected with viruses, they may start reproducing more quickly, and that could trigger a cancer response. Right now, gene therapy is incredibly expensive. Recent trials would be over $1 million for just an individual. And so it's definitely not a treatment that would be available on a large scale yet. And then there's a more fundamental issue that gene therapy will only work on diseases that we know the genetic basis of. So cystic fibrosis is a great candidate for gene therapy because it's due to one gene and we know the error in the gene. But if you look at something like heart disease or many cancers, they're due to a whole variety of factors and not just one gene that needs one fix. So as I mentioned earlier, they are starting to do more gene therapy. They're still mostly doing it in model organisms, so we're talking about mice and other mammals. But there are some early clinical trials. These are phase one trials where someone is very, very ill and only a small number of individuals, usually less than 10, are getting a particular treatment. It's just proof of concept more than actual trials that will tell us if this can work for a large number of people. One of the places that they have been successful with gene therapy is the delivery of a healthy allele in eye diseases. And interestingly here, they're able to drop the virus right onto the eye, and so it doesn't have to go through the whole system. The other really interesting finding from these gene therapy eye diseases is that they only needed to change the gene in about 40% of the cell to see an overall health improvement. In a couple minutes, you can watch this video talking about some of the cell therapy we are using to fight cancer. And this has been some of the most promising gene therapy research in the last few years. GMOs, or genetically modified organisms, are something you've probably heard about in the news and certainly read about in the textbook. A genetically modified organism is just an organism with some sort of altered DNA, and there can be different levels of altering DNA. So it can be that you just edit genes within the same species. So you're changing from one allele to another, but something that's all in the same species. If we say DNA is recombinant or a species is transgenic, what we mean is we've taken the DNA from one species and added it to another species. This could be just one gene, it could be multiple genes. There's two specific topics within genetically modified organisms that I want to touch on. One is CRISPR, and one is the use of gene drives. And I have two short videos for you to watch that will talk a little bit about each one of these. These are cutting-edge aspects of genetically modified organisms. CRISPR and gene drives.